My name is Blythe Scott. I'm a mixed media artist. Everything starts with drawing, and my main themes are cityscape, architectural detail, and landscape. I feel that my background is mostly about art. It always has been about art, and this was something that was predetermined because my parents were both artists. I grew up in an old stone house, which is not unusual in Scotland. So it started really with my own experience of my own home, and then beyond that, my own city. I like the unpredictability of stone and the colours and the cracks and the crevices. I like when surfaces have been altered by time. I've talked about mixed media art before and likened it to speaking multiple languages. Even if I start with the intention that I'm only going to be working in acrylics, it just never pans out that way. I tend to exaggerate whatever I see. If there's a curve in the coastline, I will exaggerate that curve and intensify it. I intensify colour, intensify texture. So everything is just sort of taken up a notch. There are all sorts of things that I notice on a daily basis. I think most artists are the same. They remark on the way a shiny surface meets a matte surface, or the variety of a line, or the twist in a road. I'll go out with a camera to notice things. The reason I take a camera is so that I can very, very quickly gather lots of information in a short period of time. I also take drawing materials. It's about loosening up, being expressive, looking at the essence of things. Am I looking for line? Am I looking for tone, texture, form, colour? There'll be something that I am predominantly looking for, and I won't necessarily look at any more than one visual element at a time. It just makes me less uptight about details. Yeah, anything you can do to fool your brain that you're not doing what you're doing. Like drawing upside down or several materials kind of works. If I'm out in the landscape, I find that just drawing with ink is a really great option. I quite like just to pick up sticks or use chopsticks or rough or larger materials, because I find that if I use something that's much finer, there's a tendency to focus too much on minute details. You get away from the essence of a scene, and I'm much more interested in the emotional response to a place. I'm not a clean, tidy painter by any means. I love to be sort of physically involved with the paint and scraping it or applying it with my fingers or attacking it in any way I can. I'm always in search of that intriguing surface. I use lots of different things, not just conventional things, not just things you can purchase, but things from my kitchen, things I mix up myself. So I use a lot to disrupt the surface, but I am actually drawing with the texture as well. Being a mixed media artist, I think it's really important to understand each of these media individually, to understand their properties and also to understand what you can put on top of what, archivally. And layering is super important to me because I want people to look at my pieces and ask how, why. I want people to step a little bit more closely and have reasons to step more closely and be intrigued by the variety of the surface. I want to create a sense that you could stand to the left or to the right and experience a painting in a different way. It will give you more. As I get up to the finer layers, the tools get smaller, the materials become more fluid. I might use inks, I might use pastels, anything that will make a mark, actually. I hope my work is uplifting. I was taught by my parents always to try to improve the world with art. It's great when you go out into the landscape and you personally are affected by a location, but it's so much more fun to share that. For most artists, they're trying to communicate something of their experience of the world. I'm trying to say to people, this is what it feels like to be there. Mostly, this is just the life in my head. This is how far I've taken this thought, and this is where the daydream ended up.